warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back children for the class 8 standard, and today we are going to study the topic culture in sociology. So sociology, what do you mean by sociology? Studies about human beings, the life of human beings. A person who study about the life of human beings is called anthropologist. Anthropology is the study of human beings. So here we are going to study about the topic culture. Before highlighting our points on culture, let us study about sociology. What does sociology define us and make us understand about the environment, nature, and self-created social world since ages? So can we live alone? No, we cannot live alone. Imagine you are fought with your siblings. Can you be alone? How long you can be alone without your siblings? So again, you want to be a very good cooperative with your siblings. You try to speak, you try to have fun, entertain your friends. So without your friends also you will be alone. So human being without and another individual, he cannot be alone in society. If he is alone also, he try to speak himself, standing in front of mirror, speaking to himself while dressing. Yes, I look handsome, my hairstyle, my your my clothes. So he speaks to himself by seeing the mirror. So that comes here, one kind of behavior where he is doing alone in front of mirror. The change of behavior of a human being, individual in a society, he thinks generally whether individual can live alone or not. So here, where we have the created things of nature, Almighty has gifted us so many things to the nature and we use it. But can we live alone without friends? No, we need a friend to speak, to entertain, to share our feelings, to play. So we live in a society, we share everything. So here we are going to study about the sociology. The sociology meaning originates from two words. One is called sociology. Socius of Latin language means companion, and logos of Greek language means science of study. So this defines about the sociology. The father of sociology is known as Auguste Comte. So he is the father of sociology. So now let us study about Auguste Comte. Auguste Comte was born in the year 1798. He is an important French philosopher. He is the first social philosopher, earliest. So there are two. One is called the earliest and the one more sociologists are defined into two. That is to the earliest and to the present. So he is the earliest sociologist, that is Auguste Comte. He is called the father of sociology. He studied society scientifically and provided the status of science for sociology. Auguste Comte was strongly supported by the other early sociologists like Herbert Spencer, Emily Durkheim, Max Weber, and Comte used the word sociology for the first time while delivering a public lecture on positive philosophy. So he is a person shown a way of sociology, studying about the human beings, that man cannot live alone in society, and what is his behavior. So now let us move to the topic called culture. What is this culture? Culture means the transfer of knowledge, experience, belief, value, behavior, relation from generation to generation. Yes, this teaches culture. So this culture, from where do we learn? Do we learn outside? No, we learn from our family. So family teaches how to behave, how to respect. So these all things we learn from our family. Our first school is our home and first teacher is mother. And the later, from the school we learn the things. So the culture, it's a progress in lifestyle, literature, music, science and technology that's given to human society. Culture makes human society unique and meaningful. The way of dress we wear, it should be unique. Yes, if you are wearing a traditional costume also, that means we have to think of the society, that we are living in a society. Yes, we are cultured family, so and so we have to follow these things here. We cannot break the culture. The culture, according to this, there's a beautiful definition given by sociologist, is called as E.B. Tyler. He says culture is a complex whole which includes knowledge, belief, art, rules and regulations, traditions, and any other capabilities earned by the human being as a member of society. He said the culture include knowledge. Yes, it includes the knowledge. From where do we get the knowledge? The knowledge from the books, the knowledge from, which is given right from our family. Belief, yes, we believe for everything. Art, rules and regulation. Can we break the rules and regulation? No, we cannot go beyond the rules and regulation. Traditions, which our family follows from generations to generation. We cannot break those traditions. So here, according to E.B. Taylor, he defines culture means a group of the human being a member of society. If you are living in a society, we have to follow this. But according to Malinowski, he says it is a tool of human being to design his aims of life is called culture. No, it is not a knowledge, it is not a belief, it is not an art and regulation, only a man aim. An example, a man, he wants to be a pilot. Only his aim is to be a pilot. Can he should not undergo with this knowledge and rules and regulation? Yes, he want to succeed, he want to be a success, he want to be a good achiever in a, to fulfill his aim, he has to follow this. So it includes the aim, so knowledge, rules and regulations, art, belief and everything. Then only he can achieve his aim. Without society, yes, my aim is to be an engineer and a pilot and a doctor. No. So he should follow the member. He is living in a society, he should follow this culture. Then only he can be a successor in his achievement goal. Now here, according to Ogburn, he defined the types of culture into, one is called the material culture and non-material culture. What is this material culture and non-material culture? Material culture is created by human beings by converting. Yes, we all are human beings. So we want to live, we need a shelter. Where do we live? Do we live on the street? No. We try to construct a house here with the help of our labor. The construct people, those who are talented, they try to build up the houses. So material cultures include like man-made resources like house, building, bridge, road, dam, machines. We can see this. We can see the man activity, what is doing it. So it is called a material culture. And the second comes here. Civilization, material culture in the sense of civilization. A house constructed, every facility is present in a house here, so we can survive our life. If one thing is when absent, there is no water facility, what do? We face a water problem. So that means your civilization, a man is living, that comes here for material culture. Non-material culture, what it comes for traditional. Yes, he is civilized here, but other thing he should follow when he is living in a society. That is non-material culture comes under tradition, belief, ritual, custom, moral value, ideas, literature, language, religion. Yes, so these things also, this is called as a non-material. Can we build up this? No. This from where do we get? We get from our family where they are learned from there. It is an heredity, inheritance. Now, my parents, they have learned from their parents. So my parents teach me and I teach my children. So it is a continuous process. Imagine for the occasion of the marriage, if something is missing here, a ritual, can it take place? No. So we follow each and every tradition, each and every ritual in very particular form. So that comes here for non-material culture.